I'm going to show you four of the coolest upcoming mobile technologies that are going to be in your next phone. First up is UFS 2.0, Universal Flash Storage 2.0. Now, faster flash storage isn't a very sexy technology, but it's really important. If you think about it, it's how fast your apps will load, how fast your phone boots up, how fast you can save off all those high-resolution images. UFS 2.0 doubles the speed of the flash inside your phone. It's already in the Galaxy S6, and you're gonna see it in a lot of other phones in the next year or two. How about charging your phone with the sun? Kyocera is showing off a technology that lets the display on your phone be a solar charging panel. So all you have to do is leave your phone in the sun for a few minutes to top it off. We're always looking for ways to make the batteries in our phones last longer. It's pretty cool to think that anytime sunlight's hitting it, it's charging it up. Now, we're familiar with the fingerprint sensors on the iPhone, and they have them on the Galaxy phones, and they don't always work that great. Qualcomm may have a solution with its ultrasonic fingerprint sensor. It can be hidden in the base of the phone without even any little pad or glass over it. And when you put your thumb on it, ultrasonic waves go into your finger, creating a 3D fingerprint that will go through oils and dirt and dust and stuff like that on your finger. So it may be really reliable, and finally we'll have fingerprint sensors that just work. And of course, no talk of future mobile technology would be complete without mentioning 5G. Now, of course, we still have a long way to go on 4G LTE. It's got a lot of growth potential, but they're already testing out and trying to get working the 5G that will replace it. And we're talking about speeds over 7 gigabits per second. That's downloading a whole high-def movie in seconds. Now, you're gonna need all that kind of speed for future technologies like holograms and stuff. You're gonna need your phone to have a faster connection than your landline at home does today. And that's way off. It's gonna be 5 years before you get a phone with 5G, but a lot of this other technology is coming soon enough to be in your next phone. And for me, I can't wait for it.